Welcome on PCR TV at EuroPCR. I'm Professor Atul Patak from Clinique Pasteur in Toulouse, France, and I'm happy and glad to welcome Professor Sergio Berti from Italy, Pisa, who is heading the Department of Cardiovascular Medicine at the National Council Research Hospital. What I really want you to share with the audience is the highlights in the field of heart failure and interventions on heart failure. So can you just share with us what are your thoughts about the burden of heart failure from an epidemiological standpoint and a clinical view?
Thank you, Atul. The heart failure is a great clinical and social problem. If just to think that in the general population the prevalence of heart failure is 1 to 2%, and if we take into account people older than 70, the percentage increases to 10%. So it's a very big medical and social problem. The medical treatment changed the natural history and the outcome of our patient, and beside the medical treatment, we have several therapeutic options, mainly based on transcatheter therapy. And especially in the last 10 years, we saw the development of new technology that ranged from the cardiac arrest synchronization to the transcatheter treatment of the mitral regurgitation to the treatment of the with the neuromodulator change the neurohormonal balance in the patient with the cardiac failure.
Okay, so there have been a lot of excitement about this new approach, the intra-atrial shunt. Can you give us some insight about what is behind the pathophysiology and how is this procedure working?
To create a shunt between the left and the right atrium is a very exciting perspective. In this EuroPCR, we had a great session and in which we addressed this problem from a physiopathological point of view and from technical point of view. The physiopathologic basis is that the wedge pressure increased during physical exercise and became a limitation for the level of physical exercise. If we create a shunt at the level of the left atrium, we decrease, we compress the left atrium, and we increase the level of physical exercise. So in other words, we change the quality of life of our patient with cardiac failure.
Okay, so maybe as an interventional cardiologist, can you give us some details about the procedure, the technique? How does it work?
The procedure is relatively easy. We need to do a transseptal puncture with broken bow technology, the traditional strategy that we use for to get the left atrium. We advance a stiff wire, and over the stiff wire we advance a large catheter for the delivery device. The device is open partially in the left atrium and then is completely released at the level of the septum. From technical point of view, we have two philosophy of devices. The first is a continuous shunt, and the second technological philosophy is the unidirectional shunt from the left to right atrium with a mechanism similarly to a valve.
So in practice, what are the data and in which type of patient has this device been tested? Can you just summarize us the key features about trials in the field?
At present, we have a trial in a very small population. In two different kind of patient with the normal ejection fraction and heart failure, and patient with severe decrease left ventricular function. The results are really very promising, especially for the quality of life. At present, it's difficult to imagine what is the impact on the outcome in terms of life expectancy of this patient. The results are really very promising, and this technique seems really effective.
And what about safety? Some comments about safety?
The intra-procedural safety is really very, very high because the peri-procedural complication is extremely low.
And so if we try to put this into perspective, how do you see the future of these approaches and more generally the way we can improve the quality of management for our heart failure patients?
I think that the treatment of heart failure should be a multi-therapeutical approach. The shunt is one of the approach that integrate all the other therapeutical approach, and I think that we have to make an effort to personalize the treatment on the basis of the clinical aspect of the patient.
Thank you very much, Sergio. Very exciting information, and let's follow up these nice and exciting stories about interventions in heart failure.
My pleasure. Thanks, Eto'o.